Hello everybody, welcome to IPA Explore. We're here in the heart of the Charnwood Forest to do a little walk around on the Mount St Bernard Abbey. So,
Monastery.
So there it is behind me, look. Magnificent piece of architecture. And if you watch one of our other videos, an investigation at the Mount St Bernard's reformatory, that was where the abbey used to be until it was became a reformatory, which is now just ruins in a woodland. And then it was built here, I think 1890 something or something. It'll be in the description anyway. So beautiful. The grounds are beautiful. If you've never been here before, get yourself here, have a little walk around. It's peaceful and you can bring the dogs here as well. It's free parking.
We have our new badges.
Yeah, we've got our new badges, look. IPA Exploration. So yeah, all cool. So hope you enjoy the video. There it is. That way. Go inside first. Keep the volume down a bit. Designed by Augustin Hugin. Thank you. Loads of books here. We have an honesty box. So you just put what you think it's worth in that box. Not actually a box, it's a gap in the wall there. That's handy. We've got that one. I think so. They use a crystal. I reckon if someone built this, they sort of quarried all this out, built this. That's what they say. Use this as a quarry. And I do like the little shields. Down high. Rain high. Rain high. The little flower that's on there. They're actually made out of lead. You can see the flower. Can't necessarily go in there, we'll have to get around this way. Calvary walks. Upwards and onwards. Built out of this white crystal rock.
Okay.
That's come down this way. To the side of the monastery. And the dormitories and the rooms where they sleep. And that and no, I won't go that way. That would be less time, we'll follow it. There's a top there as well, you can get down there, you have to follow this pathway. Follow the pathway round. There's plenty to see here, but it's mainly just for probably, I would say, sort of an adult's day out. I don't think it's all cheer for kids to do. I like how these steps in this dry stone wall is all built out of the same type of rock, typical of the strong forest rock. They're actually built into to the actual rocky outcrops as well. Probably over time, but it's just nice how it all, the whole lot just blends in. Our nature's over, tried to overtake, claim it back. We'll get to see that close up in a bit. Our little rest area there. It's all the moss as well that grows on the rock. Yeah, the trees grow out between the rocks. Rhododendrons, typical of the Charles Forest, get them around Beacon Hill. Yeah. Okay, that's the way we've just come up. Yeah. Then it just spirals round. Follow it around. Yeah, no, it should be coming from that direction, really. That's another view from here. See how wildlife have blended all in. That's locked. Can't go that way. That goes into the garden that way. So we go up. Then the steps. Descend steps. Suppose the idea that monks have is they use it like a retreat, a prayer retreat sort of thing. They climb up really high so they can be closer to heaven, something like that. Just a theory. You look over the edge, you can just see how far down it is. Camera doesn't do any justice. Look at the distance over there. Amazing view. This is roughly near the top because the rest of it's built up, as you can see here. The rest of it's all built up of single bricks, individual rocks. And the other thing is nice as well. People have actually brought little trinkets and things to remember their loved ones. Photos and things, and little trinkets. Quite nice, nice little thought. We're talking about the highest point at the moment we are. That beautiful view. Pretty splendid. There's the monastery itself in its full glory. We're going to get access to that area in a moment. We have to come up this road here. Can't go in the building. Have a look. There's a cemetery at the back there. So we'll have a quick look at that in a moment. Almost forgot, on the top of this bit here, got the statue of the crucifixion of Christ, probably Mary and Magdalene. They probably purchased a lot of these from the gift shop that's here. And then put them here in memory of somebody that they've lost. That's snowflake obsidian, that is. Quite a nice little thought that is. And we descend steps downwards, but this is So that's the way we came through there. So we go down these steps. Send the steps to this level here. Let's see how high we are. Pretty high all. Lovely trees as well, how it all blends in with the nature as well. And then go down these steps. Some of it's been partially built up there as well. That there looks like a channel, what water flows down from the top there. Yeah, so that section there has been built up. This is natural area here. These rocks look like they've been placed there. The water tank. This is the best part, I think, because it's like you've got nature blended in with the rocks, and I like that sort of thing. Just notice this as well. If you look down there, it looks like there was one sort of a tunnel or something that's been bricked up. There, look. Rumour has it that there was tunnels leading from here that were the places monks used to use them. Whether that's true or not, I don't know, but I reckon that one of them led to Gunhill House area. So we come down to this level and see that archway a bit better there. Look, see how it's bricked up. It was definitely an opening of some sort, because if you look across the top here, you like the archway, definitely some form of. And it's also got a slab roof as well, flat roof, so it was definitely something. So here we've come down to a small little chapel. Again built out of the usual rocks. There we are, on the forest rock. Sandstone is literally brought in. So yeah, this is the little chapel that we've got, the prayer chapel, statues there, alabaster.
Right, let's just, so that's where we've just been, where that little chapel is, and then walk down this way. Everywhere you go, roses and flowers. Obviously, monks spend some time doing the gardening as well as doing their studies, prayers. Oh. This is nice. We've got more chestnut trees. There's more rocky outcrops here. Look. Yeah. Little statue there, little prayer point here, look. That's nice. There's more to see, a lot more to see here. Yeah. A bit of gardens here. I think the monks do some of the gardening, but they have contractors in as well to do the heavy work. So, all that way is where the rocky outcrops is. There's a Cistercian statue on the top left. This here is another way. that's you can get through that way instead of going round. This is nice, covered in trees, nice and cool. Gated as well. Yeah, so you've got the outcrops here again, protruding out of it. And the other side, you've got the dry stone wall. 1953, this bit here was built up. I think that means this section here. Not going that way though. This way. Yeah. No, I just want to do this bit here. So yeah, so you can cut through here, this way. Yeah, there's a school trip here. And then down here there's a statue of a king. I'm not sure what king it is. If anybody knows, put the description, the comment section below. I don't know what it is. There's a lot of horse chestnuts on the floor here. Conker season. Yeah, so here we've got another statue. So if you know what statue king that is, you pop it in the comments below. Right, so if you're in a car, you have to go to the car park, you're not there for guests only. So we'll head up that way and take a look. There's a bit more to see up here. Honkers are dropping. Good job, no, they're standing there.
That old man, pretending to have a golf club float and he hit it.
Also, there's like a tunnel doorway there, look. What if that's all interlinked? I wonder what that is. Yeah, that's a lot better. McCormick International.
Old.
Quite an old one. 1950s, maybe. Right, we've got to walk up here. We can only go 5 miles per hour. More rock there. I like to see that. I like to see trees, shrubs and rocks.
Yeah. And mud.
But then the view of the other side, onto the right hand side, is the sheep field. Looking a bit sheepish today. Don't mention lamb mint sauce. I mentioned it once, but I think I got away with it. Or failing that, mention rosemary instead. Resting area there.
Mint sauce and rosemary.
Don't say it too loud. I've got a thing about mint sauce and rosemary. I wonder why. That tree, how it's growing out the rocks there, look.
Amazing.
Like mangroves, look. Like mangrove swamps. Squirrel. Oh.
Down there, look.
Very, very back of that tree. Nice to see. Yeah, this road leads to the back end of the monastery where the, I think, the Tint Meadow Brewery is. So if you've never had any of that beer, get over to here, to the gift shop, and you can buy the beer in a small brown bottle. It is nice beer, but it's very strong. It's about 7% volume, gravity, alcohol. Very strong beer. You can buy, I think it's 12 bottles for 30 something pounds. Bad bargain.
But it all goes to the monastery.
Yeah. That's how they met the money. They met the money through gifts and beer. Years ago, they used to make the money from the dairy products and things. Just like here, we've got like a little another prayer chapel.
Hidden cave
sort of thing. Again, built out the usual charred forest rock. Another little shrine here.
nice, all hidden in these trees.
You have to look very carefully because you can walk straight past it. It's not very visible from out here, as you can see there. It's not very visible. You can walk past it quite easily. Oh, there's a little pond here. Interesting. And there's actually fish in it. All fish. Quite nice. There's an open little external outdoor chapel for sermons. So we'll head down that way. Yeah, there's not that really that much to see, but now. If you look at one of our other paranormal videos of the old schoolhouse in Coville, you'd see that the architect's design is very similar. Yeah. That's because it was built by August Pugin. He's the architect of this place and that old school. So there's the Tint Meadow van, that's the delivery van for the beer, Tint Meadow. It's a Trappist ale. They used to brew that here many, many years ago, then they stopped brewing it and then they started again. It's a very nice beer, but very strong. Just how we like it. Here's the mini cemetery. Not going to look at some of the newer graves because we don't look at newer graves, but we do look at the very old ones. It's well, I just think it's a bit disrespectful really, if it's a newer grave, having the village still alive. Yeah, I once thought that, I knew there was a cemetery here, but I didn't think it was this small. I thought it would be bigger. I also thought it was just for the monks only. I thought it was just them that was buried here. Turns out anybody can. Bot, yes, it is. Horsewick. 6 in that one. Some of them range from 1800, late 1800, early 1900 at the moment. Not, I don't know what the oldest one is here. I've noticed something else as well. Usual standard materials are headstones normally built of in Leicestershire and Charnwood are usually slate, mine at Swithin slate quarries. Here, seen one yet, Swithin slate. That's very unusual. More or less sandstone here. Sandstone or marble, or like these two here, which are solid polished granite. And beautiful polished granite as well. Look. And they are. Well, that's 1965. Then we've got the black marble, 1917. And Lyle one there, look, in memory of Everard Aloysius of the Royal 60th Rifle, second son of Ambrose March Philip, the Lyle of Garenham Park, Garrett Grace Dew Manor, born 28th, 5th, 1835, performed valiantly at the storming of the water bastion in Delhi, 14th of May 1857, killed in Delhi, and one of the BC students. There's another one, Phillips de Lisle, might read that, crazy. There's another one. Wow, so we've got de Lisle burials, de Lisle family here. And like I says, I thought this was just the monk's cemetery, but it turns out that it's anybody's interred here, really. Don't know how you get to be interred here. There's that one. Seen that one a minute ago. Patron soul of Winifred Nee de Lisle, which was once de Lisle, widow of Edward, Lord Howard of Gloucester, died soon. 1909. Another de Lisle. Bernard CMP. Died November 10th, 1921. Composer of many operas and musical works. Only brother of CMP. Garendon and Gracedieu. Wow. Very interesting. So there's a lot of the Lisle family here. We can find any more. Ah, there we go, there's another one. Mark Phillips de Lisle, right? Here's another one, March, Lyle, Ambrose, Paul Jordan, died 8th September. Lyle, and there's another one here, March, Phillips, Lyle, Everard, died 1947. Oh, yeah. So, some of the de Lisle family here. Now the roots are lifting up this path. The size of that one. On that pine tree there. Amazing. Not very often you see iron crosses, is it, in the cemetery? Yeah, that one over there. Yeah, it could be. That's a temporary marker, that is. You usually put that in until they replace it. That's a nice statue. Maybe a bit of nerd on. So he's probably from. Eh? Yeah. Oh, missed that one. Interesting, isn't it? Yeah, so that's the Mount St Bernard Cemetery, and that's just at the back of the monastery. That the actual monastery. Not
quite sure what
we
can do to be
About wraps it up then, really. Not much more to see, that's everything on the monastery, top of those rocks, and at the back end the cemetery.
Well guys, we hope you enjoyed that video. It was quite a long video, longer than we expected, but you can't do loads of footages of different areas in one short video. We hope you enjoyed that as we enjoyed filming it. And don't forget to click that notification bell, subscribe for the latest videos, and check out our ghost hunting videos, junior IPA, and our other exploration videos. Until next time, take care, be good, keep safe.
Alleluia, Alleluia.